This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Tennis is a racket sport that can be played individually against a single opponent singles or between two teams of two players each doubles. Each player uses a tennis racket that is strung with cord to strike a hollow rubber ball covered with felt over or around a net and into the opponent's court. The object of the game is to play the ball in such a way that the opponent is not able to play a valid return. The player who is unable to return the ball will not gain a point, while the opposite player will. Tennis is an Olympic sport and is played at all levels of society and at all ages. The sport can be played by anyone who can hold a racket, including wheelchair users. The modern game of tennis originated in Birmingham, England, in the late 19th century as lawn tennis. It had close connections both to various field lawn games such as croquet and bowls, as well as to the older racket sport of real tennis during most of the 19th century. In fact, the term tennis referred to real tennis, not lawn tennis. For example, in Disraelis' novel Sybil 1845, Lord Eugene De Vere announces that he will go down to Hampton Court and play tennis. The rules of tennis have changed little since the 1890s. Two exceptions are that from 1908 to 1961 the server had to keep one foot on the ground at all times, and the adoption of the tiebreak in the 1970s. A recent addition to professional tennis has been the adoption of electronic review technology coupled with a point challenge system, which allows a player to contest the line call of a point, a system known as Hawkeye. Tennis is played by millions of recreational players and is also a popular worldwide spectator sport. The four Grand Slam tournaments, also referred to as the majors, are especially popular. The Australian Open played on hard courts, the French Open played on red clay courts, Wimbledon played on grass courts, and the US Open played also on hard courts. Contents 1 History 11 Predecessors 12 Origins of the modern game 2 Equipment 21 Rackets 22 Balls 23 Miscellaneous 3 Manner of play 31 Court 311 lines 32 play of a single point 33 scoring 331 game, set, match. 3311 game 3312 set 3313 match 332 special point terms 3321 game point 3322 break point 34 rule variations 4 officials 5 junior tennis 6 match play 61 continuity 62 ball changes 63 on court coaching 7 shots 71 grip 72 serve 73 forehand 74 backhand 75 other shots 8 injuries 9 tournaments 91 Grand Slam tournaments 92 men's tournament structure 921 Masters 1000 922 250 and 500 Series 923 Challenger Tour and Futures tournaments 93 women's tournament structure 931 Premier events 932 international events 10 players 101 professional players 102 Grand Slam tournament winners 103 greatest male players 104 greatest female players 11 in popular culture 12 see also 13 references 14 further reading 15 external links History main article, History of Tennis Predecessors Jeu de Paume in the 17th century Historians believe that the game's ancient origin lay in 12th century northern France, where a ball was struck with the palm of the hand. Louis X of France was a keen player of Jeu de Paume, Game of the Palm, which evolved into real tennis, and became notable as the first person to construct indoor tennis courts in the modern style. Louis was unhappy with playing tennis outdoors and accordingly had indoor, enclosed courts made in Paris around the end of the 13th century. In due course this design spread across royal palaces all over Europe in June 1316 at Vincennes, Val-de-Marne and following a particularly exhausting game, Louis drank a large quantity of cooled wine and subsequently died of either pneumonia or pleurisy. Although there was also suspicion of poisoning because of the contemporary accounts of his death, Louis X is history's first tennis player known by name. Another of the early enthusiasts of the game was King Charles V of France, who had a court set up at the Louvre. Palace. It wasn't until the 16th century that rackets came into use, and the game began to be called tennis, from the French term tennis, which can be translated as hold, receive, or take, an interjection used as a call from the server to his opponent. It was popular in England and France, although the game was only played indoors where the ball could be hit off the wall. Henry VIII of England was a big fan of this game, which is now known as real tennis. During the 18th century and early 19th century, as real tennis declined, new racket sports emerged in England. England further, the patenting of the first lawn mower in 1830, in Britain, is strongly believed to have been the catalyst, worldwide, for the preparation of modern-style grass courts, sporting ovals, playing fields, pitches, greens, etc. This in turn led to the codification of modern rules for many sports, including lawn tennis, most football codes, lawn bowls and others. Origins of the modern game. Augurio Pereira's house in Edgbaston, Birmingham, where he and Harry Jem first played the modern game of lawn tennis between 1859 and 1865. Harry Jem and his friend Augurio Pereira developed a game that combined elements of rackets and the basketball game pelota, which they played on Pereira's croquet. Lawn in Birmingham, England, United Kingdom in 1872, along with two local doctors, they founded the world's first tennis club in Leamington Spa in December 1873. British Army officer Major Walter Clopton Wingfield designed and patented a similar game. Officers play. She laid out a tennis court at the Staten Island Cricket Club at Camp Washington, Tompkinsville, Staten Island, New York. The first American national championship was played there in September 1880. An Englishman named O. E. Woodhouse won the singles title, and a silver cup worth $100, by defeating Canadian I. F. Helmuth. There was also a doubles match which was won by a local pair. There were different rules at each club. The ball in Boston was larger than the one normally used in New York. On 21 May 1881. The United States National Lawn Tennis Association, now the United States Tennis Association, was formed to standardize the rules and organize competitions. The U.S. National Men's Singles Championship, now the U.S. Open, was first held in 1881 at the Newport Casino, Newport, Rhode Island. The U.S. National Women's Singles Championships were first held in 1887 in Philadelphia. Tennis doubles final at 1896 Olympic Games. Tennis also became popular in France, where the French Championships dates to 1891, although until 1925 it was open only to tennis players who were members of French clubs. Thus, Wimbledon, the U.S. Open, the French Open, and the Australian Open dating to 1905 became and have remained the most prestigious events in tennis. Together these four events are called the majors or slams, a term borrowed from bridge rather than baseball. Lawn tennis in Canada, ca. 1900. The comprehensive rules promulgated in 1924 by the International Lawn Tennis Federation, now known as the International Tennis Federation ITF, have remained largely stable in the ensuing 80 years, the one major change being the addition of the tiebreak system designed by Jimmy Van Allen that same year. Tennis withdrew from the Olympics after the 1924 Games but returned 60 years later as a 21 and under demonstration event in 1984. This reinstatement was credited by the efforts by the then ITF President Philippe Chatrier, ITF General Secretary David Gray and ITF Vice President Pablo Lorraines, and support from IOC President Juan Antonio Samaranch. The success of the event was overwhelming and the IOC decided to reintroduce tennis as a full medal sport at Seoul in 1988. International Tennis Hall of Fame at the Newport Casino. The Davis Cup, an annual competition between men's national teams, dates to 1900. The analogous competition for women's national teams, the Fed Cup, was founded as the Federation Cup in 1963 to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the founding of the ITF. In 1926, promoter C.C. Pyle established the first professional tennis tour with a group of American and French tennis players playing exhibition matches to paying audiences. The most notable of these early professionals were the American Vinnie Richards and the Frenchwoman Suzanne Lenglen. Once a player turned pro, he or she could not compete in the major amateur tournaments. In 1968, commercial pressures and rumors of some amateurs taking money under the table led to the abandonment of this distinction, inaugurating the open era, in which all players could compete in all tournaments, and top players were able to make their living from tennis. With the beginning of the open era, the establishment of an international professional tennis circuit, and revenues from the sale of television rights, tennis's popularity has spread worldwide, and the sport has shed its middle-class English-speaking image. Although it is acknowledged that this stereotype still exists, in 1954, Van Allen founded the International Tennis Hall of Fame, a non-profit museum in Newport, Rhode Island. The building contains a large collection of tennis memorabilia as well as a Hall of Fame honoring prominent members and tennis players from all over the world each year. A grass court tournament and an induction ceremony honoring new Hall of Fame members are hosted on its grounds. Equipment. Main article, tennis technology. Part of the appeal of tennis stems from the simplicity of equipment required for play. Beginners need only a racket and balls. Racket's main article, racket sports equipment section. The components of a tennis racket include a handle, known as the grip, connected to a neck which joins a roughly elliptical frame that holds a matrix of tightly pulled strings. For the first 100 years of the modern game, rackets were made of wood and of standard size, and strings were of animal gut laminated wood construction yielded more strength in rackets used through most of the 20th century until first metal and then composites of carbon graphite, ceramics, and lighter metals such as titanium were introduced. These stronger materials enabled the production of oversized rackets that yielded yet more power. Meanwhile, technology led to the use of synthetic strings that match the feel of gut yet with added durability. Under modern rules of tennis, the rackets must adhere to the following guidelines: the hitting area, composed of the strings, must be flat and generally uniform. The frame of the hitting area may not be more than 29 inches 74. 1997, when it was shortened to 29 inches 74. Materials in the region. Miscellaneous advanced players improve their performance through a number of accoutrements. Vibration dampeners may be interlaced in the proximal part of the string array for improved feel. Racket handles may be customized with absorbent or rubber-like materials to improve the player's grip. Players often use sweat bands on their wrists to keep their hands dry and head bands or bandanas to keep the sweat out of their eyes as well. Finally, although the game can be played in a variety of shoes, specialized tennis shoes have wide, flat soles for stability and a built-up front structure to avoid excess wear. Manner of play. The dimensions of a tennis court. Two players before a serve for individual terms. See Glossary of Tennis Court. Main article: Tennis court. Tennis is played on a rectangular, flat surface. The court is 78 feet 2,377. A net is stretched across the full width of the court, parallel with the baselines, dividing it into two equal ends. It is held up by either a metal cable or cord that can be no more than 0.8. Called the doubles sidelines. These are the boundaries used when doubles is being played. The lines to the inside of the doubles sidelines are the singles sidelines and are used as boundaries in singles play. The area between a doubles sideline and the nearest singles sideline is called the doubles alley, which is considered playable in doubles play. The line that runs across the center of a player's side of the court is called the service line, because the serve must be delivered into the area between the service line and the net on the receiving side. Despite its name, this is not where a player legally stands when making a serve. The line dividing the service line in two is called the center line or center service line. The boxes this center line creates are called the service boxes. Depending on a player's position, he or she will have to hit the ball into one of these when serving. A ball is out only if none of it has hit the line or the area inside the lines upon its first bounce. All the lines are required to be between 1 and 2 inches 25 and 51. Game by game between the two players or teams. For each point, the server starts behind the baseline, between the center mark and the sideline. The receiver may start anywhere on their side of the net. When the receiver is ready, the server will serve. Although the receiver must play to the pace of the server in a legal service, the ball travels over the net without touching it and into the diagonally opposite service box. If the ball hits the net but lands in the service box, this is a let or net service, which is void, and the server retakes that serve. The player can serve any number of let services in a point, and they are always treated as voids and not as faults. A fault is a serve that falls long or wide of the service box, or does not clear the net. There is also a foot fault, which occurs when a player's foot touches the baseline or an extension of the center mark before the ball is hit. If the second service is also a fault, the server double faults, and the receiver wins the point. However, if the serve is in, it is considered a legal service. A legal service starts a rally, in which the players alternate hitting the ball across the net. A legal return consists of the player or team hitting the ball before it has bounced twice or hit any fixtures except the net, provided that it still falls in the server's court. A player or team cannot hit the ball twice in a row. The ball must travel past the net into the other player's court. A ball that hits the net during a rally is still considered a legal return as long as it crosses into the opposite side of the court. The first player or team to fail to make a legal return loses the point. The server then moves to the other side of the service line at the start of a new point scoring. Main article: Tennis scoring system. Breakpoint. Redirects here for software term. See breakpoint. Game, set, match. Game. A game consists of a sequence of points played with the same player serving. A game is won by the first player to have won at least 4 points in total and at least 2 points more than the opponent. The running score of each game is described in a manner peculiar to tennis. Scores from 0 to 3 points are described as love, 15, 30, and 40, respectively, if at least 3 points have been scored by each player, making the players' scores equal at 40 apiece. The score is not called out as 40-40, but rather as deuce. If at least 3 points have been scored by each side and a player has one more point than his opponent, the score of the game is advantage for the player in the lead. During informal games, advantage can also be called add-in or van-in when the serving player is ahead, and add-out or van-out when the receiving player is ahead. The scoreboard of a match between Andy Roddick and Cyril Saulnier. The score of a tennis game during play is always read with the serving player's score first in tournament play. The chair umpire calls the point count, e.g., 15 love, after each point at the end of a game. The chair umpire also announces the winner of the game and the overall score set. A set consists of a sequence of games played with service alternating between games, ending when the count of games won meets certain criteria. Typically, a player wins a set by winning at least 6 games and at least 2 games more than the opponent. If one player has won 6 games and the opponent 5, an additional game is played. If the leading player wins that game, the player wins the set 7-5. If the trailing player wins the game, a tie break is played. A tie break, played under a separate set of rules, allows one player to win one more game and thus the set, to give a final set score of 7-6. A love set means that the loser of the set won 0 games, colloquially termed a jam donut in the USA in tournament play. The chair umpire announces the winner of the set and the overall score. The final score in sets is always read with the winning player's score first, e.g., 6-2, 4-6, 6-0, 7-5. Match. A match consists of a sequence of sets. The outcome is determined through a best of 3 or 5 sets system. Recreational players may agree to play any number of sets, depending upon time availability or stamina on the professional circuit. Men play best of 5 set matches at all 4 Grand Slam tournaments, Davis Cup, and the final of the Olympic Games, and best of 3 set matches at all other tournaments, while women play best of 3 set matches at all tournaments. The first player to win 2 sets in a best of 3, or 3 sets in a best of 5, wins the match. Only in the final sets of matches at the Australian Open, the French Open, Wimbledon, the Olympic Games, Davis Cup until 2015, and Fed Cup are tie breaks not played. In these cases, sets are played indefinitely until one player has a 2-game lead, leading to some remarkably long matches in tournament play. The chair umpire announces the end of the match with the well-known phrase game, set, match, followed by the winning person's or team's name. Special point terms. Game point. A game point occurs in tennis whenever the player who is in the lead in the game needs only one more point to win the game. The terminology is extended to set. Set point, matches, match point, and even championships. Championship point. For example, if the player who is serving has a score of 40 love, the player has a triple game point, triple set point, etc. As the player has 3 consecutive chances to win the game. Game points, set points, and match points are not part of official scoring and are not announced by the chair umpire in tournament play. Breakpoint. A breakpoint occurs if the receiver, not the server, has a chance to win the game with the next point. Breakpoints are of particular importance because serving is generally considered advantageous, with servers being expected to win games in which they are serving a receiver who has 1 score of 30-40 or advantage, 2 score of 15-40 or 3 score of love. 40 consecutive chances to win the game has breakpoint, double breakpoint, or triple breakpoint, respectively. If the receiver does, in fact, win their break point, the game is awarded to the receiver, and the receiver is said to have converted their break point. If the receiver fails to win their break point, it is called a failure to convert winning break points, and thus the game is also referred to as breaking serve, as the receiver has disrupted or broken the natural advantage of the server. If in the following game the previous server also wins a break point, it is referred to as breaking back, except where tie breaks apply. At least one break of serve is required to win a set. Rule variation. See also, types of tennis match. No add from no advantage scoring method created by Jimmy Van Allen. The first player or doubles team to win 4 points wins the game, regardless of whether the player or team is ahead by 2 points. When the game score reaches 3 points each, the receiver chooses which side of the court, advantage court or deuce court, the service is to be delivered on the 7th and game deciding point. Utilized by World Team Tennis Professional Competition, ATP Tours, WTA Tours, ITF Pro Doubles and ITF Junior Doubles Pro Set. Instead of playing multiple sets, players may play one pro set. A pro set is first to 8 or 10 games by a margin of 2 games. Instead of first to 6 games, a 12-point tie break is usually played when the score is 8-8 or 10-10. These are often played with no add scoring. Match tie break. This is sometimes played instead of a third set. A match tie break, also called super tie break, is played like a regular tie break, but the winner must win 10 points instead of 7. Match tie breaks are used in the Hopman Cup, Grand Slams excluding Wimbledon, and the Olympic Games for mixed doubles. On the ATP since 2006, WTA since 2007 and ITF excluding four Grand Slam tournaments and the Davis Cup tours for doubles and as a player's choice in USTA League play another, however informal, tennis format is called Canadian doubles. This involves three players, with one person playing a doubles team. The single player gets to utilize the alleys normally reserved only for a doubles team. Conversely, the doubles team does not use the alleys. When executing a shot, the scoring is the same as a regular game. This format is not sanctioned by any official body. Australian doubles, another informal and unsanctioned form of tennis, is played with similar rules to the Canadian doubles style, only in this version, players rotate court position after each game. As such, each player plays doubles and singles over the course of a match, with the singles player always serving. Scoring styles vary, but one popular method is to assign a value of 2 points to each game, with the server taking both points if he or she holds serve and the doubles team each taking one if they break serve. Wheelchair tennis can be played by able-bodied players as well as people who require a wheelchair for mobility, and extra bounce is permitted. This rule makes it possible to have mixed wheelchair and able-bodied matches. It is possible for a doubles team to consist of a wheelchair player and an able-bodied player referred to as one up, one down, or for a wheelchair player to play against an able-bodied player. In such cases, the extra bounce is permitted for the wheelchair users. Only officials and umpire informing two players of the rules. Main article, official tennis. In most professional play and some amateur competition, there is an officiating head judge or chair umpire, usually referred to as the umpire, who sits in a raised chair to one side of the court. The umpire has absolute authority to make factual determinations. The umpire may be assisted by line judges, who determine whether the ball has landed within the required part of the court and who also call foot faults. There also may be a net judge who determines whether the ball has touched the net during service. The umpire has the right to overrule a line judge or a net judge if the umpire is sure that a clear mistake has been made. In some tournaments, line judges who would be calling the serve were assisted by electronic sensors that beep to indicate the serve was out. This system was called Cyclops. Cyclops has since largely been replaced by the Hawkeye system. In professional tournaments using this system, players are allowed 3 unsuccessful appeals per set, plus 1 additional appeal in the tie break to challenge close line calls by means of an electronic review. The US Open, Miami Masters, US Open Series, and World Team Tennis started using this challenge system in 2006, and the Australian Open and Wimbledon introduced the system in 2007 in clay court matches, such as at the French Open. A call may be questioned by reference to the mark left by the ball's impact on the court surface. The referee, who is usually located off the court, is the final authority about tennis rules. When called to the court by a player or team captain, the referee may overrule the umpire's decision if the tennis rules were violated. Question of law, but may not change the umpire's decision on a question of fact. If, however, the referee is on the court during play, the referee may overrule the umpire's decision. This would only happen in Davis Cup or Fed Cup matches, not at the World Group level. When a chair umpire from a non-neutral country is in the chair, ball boys and girls may be employed to retrieve balls, pass them to the players, and hand players their towels. They have no adjudicative role in rare events, e.g., if they are hurt or if they have caused a hindrance. The umpire may ask them for a statement of what actually happened. The umpire may consider their statements when making a decision. In some leagues, especially junior leagues, players make their own calls, trusting each other. To be honest, this is the case for many school and university level matches. The referee or referee's assistant, however, can be called on court at a player's request, and the referee or assistant may change a player's call in unofficiated matches. A ball is out only if the player entitled to make the call is sure that the ball is out. Junior tennis. Main article, junior tennis. In tennis, a junior is a player under 18 who is still legally protected by a parent or guardian. Players on the main adult tour who are under 18 must have documents signed by a parent or guardian. These players, however, are still eligible to play in junior tournaments. The International Tennis Federation (ITF) conducts a junior tour that allows juniors to establish a world ranking, and an Association of Tennis Professionals ATP or Women's Tennis Association WTA ranking. Most juniors who enter the international circuit do so by progressing through ITF, Satellite, Future, and Challenger tournaments before entering the main circuit. The latter three circuits also have adults competing in them. Some juniors, however, such as Australian Leighton Hewitt and Frenchman Gael Monfils, have catapulted directly successfully from the Junior Tour to the ATP Tour by dominating the junior scene or by taking advantage of opportunities given to them to participate in professional tournaments. In 2004, the ITF implemented a new rankings scheme to encourage greater participation in doubles, by combining two rankings, singles and doubles, into one combined tally. Junior tournaments do not offer prize money except for the Grand Slam tournaments, which are the most prestigious junior events. Juniors may earn income from tennis by participating in the future, satellite, or challenger tours. Tournaments are broken up into different tiers offering different amounts of ranking points, culminating with grade A. Leading juniors are allowed to participate for their nation in the Junior Fed Cup and Davis Cup competitions. To succeed in tennis often means having to begin playing at a young age to facilitate and nurture a junior's growth in tennis. Almost all tennis-playing nations have developed a junior development system. Juniors develop their play through a range of tournaments on all surfaces, accommodating all different standards of play. Talented juniors may also receive sponsorships from governing bodies or private institutions. Match play convention dictates that two players shake hands at the end of a match. Continuity. A tennis match is intended to be continuous because stamina is a relevant factor. Arbitrary delays are not permitted in most cases. Service is required to occur no more than 20 seconds after the end of the previous point. This is increased to 90 seconds when the player's change ends after every odd-numbered game, and a 2-minute break is permitted between sets. Other than this, breaks are permitted only when forced by events beyond the player's control, such as rain, damaged footwear, damaged racket, or the need to retrieve an errant ball. Should a player be determined to be stalling repeatedly, the chair umpire may initially give a warning followed by subsequent penalties of point, game, and default of the match for the player who is consistently taking longer than the allowed time limit. In the event of a rain delay, darkness, or other external conditions halting play, the match is resumed at a later time, with the same score as at the time of the delay, and the players at the same end of the court when rain halted play, or at the same position north or south if play is resumed on a different court. Ball changes. Balls wear out quickly in serious play and, therefore, in ATP and WTA tournaments, they are changed after every 9 games, with the first change occurring after only 7 games, because the first set of balls is also used for the pre-match warm-up as a courtesy to the receiver. The server will often signal to the receiver before the first serve of the game in which new balls are used as a reminder that they are using new balls. However, in ITF tournaments like Fed Cup, the balls are changed in a 9-11 style. Continuity of the balls condition is considered part of the game, so if a re-warm-up is required after an extended break in play usually due to rain, then the re-warm-up is done using a separate set of balls, and use of the match balls is resumed only when play resumes on court. Coaching. A recent rule change is to allow coaching on court on a limited basis during a match. This has been introduced in women's tennis for WTA Tour events in 2009 and allows the player to request her coach once per set. Shots. Main article, tennis shots. A competent tennis player has 8 basic shots in his or her repertoire: the serve, forehand, backhand, volley, half volley, overhead smash, drop shot, and lob. Grip. Main article, grip tennis. A grip is a way of holding the racket in order to hit shots during a match. The grip affects the angle of the racket face when it hits the ball and influences the pace, spin, and placement of the shot. Players use various grips during play, including the continental, the handshake grip, eastern can be either semi-eastern or full eastern, usually used for backhands, and western, semi-western or full western, usually for forehand grips. Grips. Most players change grips during a match depending on what shot they're hitting. For example, slice shots and serves call for a continental grip. Serve. Main article, serve tennis. Martina Navratilova featured on a Paraguayan stamp. A serve, or, more formally, a service in tennis is a shot to start a point. The serve is initiated by tossing the ball into the air and hitting it usually near the apex of its trajectory into the diagonally opposite service box without touching the net. The serve may be hit under or overhand, although underhand serving remains a rarity. If the ball hits the net on the first serve and bounces over into the correct diagonal box, then it is called a let, and the server gets 2 more additional serves to get it in. There can also be a let if the server serves the ball and the receiver isn't prepared. If the server misses his or her first serve and gets a let on the second serve, then they get 1 more try to get the serve in the box. Experienced players strive to master the conventional overhand serve to maximize its power and placement. The server may employ different types of serve, including flat serve, topspin serve, slice serve, and kick. American twist serve. A reverse type of spin serve is hit in a manner that spins the ball opposite the natural spin of the server, the spin direction depending upon right or left-handed. tennis if the ball is spinning counterclockwise, it will curve right from the hitter's point of view and curve left if spinning clockwise. Some servers are content to use the serve simply to initiate the point. However, advanced players often try to hit a winning shot with their serve. A winning serve that is not touched by the opponent is called an ace forehand. Main article, forehand for a right-handed player. The forehand is a stroke that begins on the right side of the body, continues across the body as contact is made with the ball, and ends on the left side of the body. There are various grips for executing the forehand, and their popularity has fluctuated over the years. The most important ones are the continental, the eastern, the semi-western, and the western. For a number of years, the small, frail 1920s player Bill Johnston was considered by many to have had the best forehand of all time, a stroke that he hit shoulder high using a Western grip. Few top players used the Western grip after the 1920s, but in the latter part of the 20th century, as shot-making techniques and equipment changed radically, the Western forehand made a strong comeback and is now used by many modern players. No matter which grip is used, most forehands are generally executed with one hand holding the racket, but there have been fine players with two-handed forehands in the 1940s and 50s. The Ecuadorian, American player Pancho Segura used a two-handed forehand to achieve a devastating effect against larger, more powerful players. Players such as Monica Seles or Francis Fabri Santoro and Marion Bartoli are also notable players known for their two-handed forehands. Backhand. Main article, backhand. Andy Murray hitting a two-handed backhand for right-handed players. The backhand is a stroke that begins on the left side of their body, continues across their body as contact is made with the ball, and ends on the right side of their body. It can be executed with either one hand or with both and is generally considered more difficult to master than the forehand. For most of the 20th century, the backhand was performed with one hand, using either an Eastern or a continental grip. The first notable players to use two hands were the 1930s Australians Vivian McGrath and John Bromwich, but they were lonely exceptions. The two-handed grip gained popularity in the 1970s as Bjorn Borg, Chris Evert, Jimmy Connors, and later Mats Wilander and Marit Safin used it to great effect, and it is now used by a large number of the world's best players, including Rafael Nadal and Serena Williams. Two hands give the player more control, while one hand can generate a slice shot, applying backspin on the ball to produce a low trajectory bounce. Reach is also limited with the two-handed shot. The player long considered to have had the best backhand of all time, Don Budge, had a powerful one-handed stroke in the 1930s and 1940s that imparted topspin onto the ball. Ken Rosewall, another player noted for his one-handed backhand, used a very accurate slice backhand through the 1950s and 1960s. A small number of players, notably Monica Seles, used two hands on both the backhand and forehand sides. Other shots: a volley is a shot returned to the opponent in mid air before the ball bounces, generally performed near the net, and is usually made with a stiff-wristed punching motion to hit the ball into an open area of the opponent's court. The half volley is made by hitting the ball on the rise just after it has bounced, also generally in the vicinity of the net, and played with the racket close to the ground. The swinging volley is hit out of the air as the player approaches the net. It is an offensive shot used to take preparation time away from the opponent, as it returns the ball into the opponent's court much faster than a standard volley from a poor defensive position on the baseline. The lob can be used as either an offensive or defensive weapon, hitting the ball high and deep into the opponent's court to either enable the lobber to get into better defensive position or to win the point outright by hitting it over the opponent's head if the lob is not hit deeply enough into the other court. However, an opponent near the net may then hit an overhead smash, a hard, serve-like shot, to try to end the point. A difficult shot in tennis is the return of an attempted lob over the backhand side of a player when the contact point is higher than the reach of a two-handed backhand. Most players will try to execute a high slice under the ball or sideways. Fewer players attempt the backhand sky hook or smash. Rarely, a player will go for a high topspin backhand while themselves in the air. A successful execution of any of these alternatives requires balance and timing, with less margin of error than the lower contact point backhands. Since this shot is a break in the regular pattern of play, if an opponent is deep in his court, a player may suddenly employ an unexpected drop shot, by softly tapping the ball just over the net so that the opponent is unable to run in fast enough to retrieve it. Advanced players will often apply back spin to a drop shot, causing the ball to skid upon landing and bounce sideways, with less forward momentum toward their opponent, or even backwards towards the net, thus making it even more difficult to return. Injuries. Main article, tennis injuries. Muscle strain is one of the most common injuries in tennis when an isolated large energy appears during the muscle contraction and at the same time body weight apply huge amount of pressure to the lengthened muscle, which can result in the occurrence of muscle strain. Inflammation inflammation and bleeding are triggered when muscle strain occur, which resulted in redness. Pain and swelling overuse is also common in tennis players from all level muscle, cartilage, nerves, bursae, ligaments and tendons may be damaged from overuse. The repetitive use of a particular muscle without time for repair and recover in the most common case among the injury tournaments. See also, list of tennis tournaments. Tournaments are often organized by gender and number of players. Common tournament configurations include men's singles, women's singles, and doubles, where two players play on each side of the net. Tournaments may be organized for specific age groups, with upper age limits for youth and lower age limits for senior players. Example of this include the Orange Bowl and Les Petits as junior tournaments. There are also tournaments for players with disabilities, such as wheelchair tennis and deaf tennis in the four Grand Slam tournaments. The singles draws are limited to 128 players for each gender. Most large tournaments seed players, but players may also be matched by their skill level according to how well a person does in sanctioned play. A player is given a rating that is adjusted periodically to maintain competitive matches. For example, the United States Tennis Association administers the National Tennis Rating Program (NTRP), which rates players between 10 and 70 in 1/2-point increments. Average club players under this system would rate 30 to 45, while world-class players would be 70 on this scale. Grand Slam tournaments. The four Grand Slam tournaments are considered to be the most prestigious tennis events in the world. They are held annually and comprise, in chronological order, the Australian Open, the French Open, Wimbledon, and the U.S. Open. Apart from the Olympic Games, Davis Cup, Fed Cup, and Hopman Cup, they are the only tournaments regulated by the International Tennis Federation (ITF), the ITF's national associations, Tennis Australia Australian Open, the Fédération Française de Tennis French Open, the Lawn Tennis Association Wimbledon, and the United States Tennis Association U.S. Open are delegated the responsibility to organize these events. Aside from the historical significance of these events, they also carry larger prize funds than any other tour event and are worth double the number of ranking points to the champion than in the next echelon of tournaments, the Masters 1000 men and Premier Events women. Another distinguishing feature is the number of players in the singles draw. There are 128, more than any other professional tennis tournament. This draw is composed of 32 seeded players, other players ranked in the world's top 100, qualifiers, and players who receive invitations through Wild Cards. Grand Slam men's tournaments have best of five set matches, while the women play best of three. Grand Slam tournaments are among the small number of events that last 2 weeks, the others being the Indian Wells Masters and the Miami Masters. Currently, the Grand Slam tournaments are the only tour events that have mixed doubles contests. Grand Slam tournaments are held in conjunction with wheelchair tennis tournaments and junior tennis competitions. These tournaments also contain their own idiosyncrasies. For example, players at Wimbledon are required to wear predominantly white. Andre Agassi chose to skip Wimbledon from 1988 through 1990, citing the event's traditionalism, particularly its predominantly white dress code. Wimbledon has its own particular methods for disseminating tickets, often leading tennis fans to follow complex procedures to obtain tickets. Grand Slam tournaments date. Tournament location. Surface prize money. First held January to February. Australian Open Melbourne hard plexicushion $40 million 2015-1905. May to June French Open Paris clay €25,018,900 2014-1891. June to July Wimbledon London grass £25 million 2014-1877. August September US Open New York City hard decoder US dollar $38,251,760 2014-1881. The international tournament began in 1925. Men's tournament structure. Masters 1000. The ATP World Tour Masters 1000 is a group of nine tournaments that form the second highest echelon in men's tennis. Each event is held annually, and a win at one of these events is worth 1,000 ranking points. When the ATP, led by Hamilton Jordan, began running the men's tour in 1990, the directors designated the top nine tournaments, outside of the Grand Slam events, as Super 9 inches events. In 2000 this became the Tennis Masters Series, and in 2004 the ATP Masters Series. In November at the end of the tennis year, the world's top 8 players compete in the ATP World Tour Finals, a tournament with a rotating locale. It is currently held in London, England. In August 2007 the ATP announced major changes to the tour that were introduced in 2009. The Masters Series was renamed to the Masters 1000, the addition of the number 1000 referring to the number of ranking points earned by the winner of each tournament contrary to earlier plans. The number of tournaments was not reduced from 9 to 8 and the Monte Carlo Masters remains part of the series although, unlike the other events, it does not have a mandatory player commitment. The Hamburg Masters has been downgraded to a 500-point event. The Madrid Masters moved to May and onto clay courts, and a new tournament in Shanghai took over Madrid's former indoor October slot as of 2011. Six of the nine 1,000 level tournaments are combined ATP and WTA events. 250 and 500 series. The third and fourth tier of men's tennis tournaments are formed by the ATP World Tour 500 series, consisting of 11 tournaments, and the ATP World Tour 250 series with 40 tournaments like the ATP World Tour Masters 1000. These events offer various amounts of prize money and the numbers refer to the amount of ranking points earned by the winner of a tournament. The Dubai Tennis Championships offer the largest financial incentive to players, with total prize money of $2,313,975. 2012. These series have various draws of 28, 32, 48 and 56 for singles and 16 and 24 for doubles. It is mandatory for leading players to enter at least four 500 events, including at least one after the U.S. Open Challenger Tour and Futures Tournaments. The Challenger Tour for men is the lowest level of tournament administered by the ATP. It is composed of about 150 events and, as a result, features a more diverse range of countries hosting events. The majority of players use the Challenger Series at the beginning of their career to work their way up the rankings. Andre Agassi, between winning Grand Slam tournaments, plummeted to world number 141 and used Challenger Series events for match experience and to progress back up the rankings. The Challenger Series offers prize funds of between $25,000 and $150,000. Below the Challenger Tour are the Futures Tournaments, events on the ITF men's circuit. These tournaments also contribute towards a player's ATP rankings points. Futures Tournaments offer prize funds of between $10,000 and $15,000. Approximately 530 Futures Tournaments are played each year. Women's Tournament Structure Premier Events.